Hello everyone, welcome back to the Olympia Schießenlager in Munich. It's the Munich finals range. We're on day four and the second of two events today. We're about to start with the men's air pistol final. Thank you very much for joining us. A warm welcome to you. My name is Shaq, and with me, I have in the commentary position, I've been chasing him for the last 2 years, and he's finally been able to join me today. It's a real pleasure to have in the commentary box, João Costa of Portugal. João, really, really nice to see you today.
Hi, nice to see you again, Shaq.
So, João finished in 14th today. How was the qualification for you? How was your shooting? You were only 2 points off the final.
Yes, the shooting was amazing. I shot very nice 10. The 10 was amazing. I've shot 24 in the 10. But then sometimes it was coming the 9. And it what happens two times more than what I was expecting, it happens. I went to 14 and not the final. But somebody must be out of the final, almost everybody.
Yeah, there's too many shooters, and well, you were one of the ones to miss out today. Jitu Rai also missed out. He finished in 10th place, only 1 point from the final. Pablo Carrera, he finished 2 points in the final with the same score as yours, Joao. He got 16 in attempts. And the 2015 European champion, Philipp Grimm of Germany, he missed out today as well.
Yep.
It's always difficult getting into the final, the margins are so small. But we're about to commence with the 8 finalists who are taking part in the air pistol final. The announcer, Jamie Stangroom, is just getting ready to introduce them to us now. So on firing position A, it's Dmitri Gergic of Serbia. Well, it's a great World Cup for the Serb. He's already won bronze in free pistol 2 days ago, and that was his first medal in that discipline.
On firing point B, representing the Republic of Korea, Olympic champion from London 2012, a tally of 9 World Cup gold medals in the 10-meter air pistol, it's Jin Jongoh.
Jin Jongoh of Korea. Already beat João Costa to the gold medal in that free pistol final here in Munich.
Yeah, but just for a short short point.
It was. Damir Mikec of Serbia. Well, he also took part in the free pistol final. He found it a little bit difficult towards the end. The Dominator is his nickname. He returns to the air pistol final as the 2016 World Cup final title holder because he won gold in Bologna last October. Seol Sung Sob of Korea, the 38-year-old, only ever made one final. That was 8th place in free pistol 10 years ago. This is his first air pistol final.
He's a familiar face here in Munich, taking the gold in this event here just last year. He's got a total of 11 world.
Ole Omelchuk, Ukraine. The 2014 European champion returns to the Munich finals hall as last year's gold medalist at this most traditional of World Cups.
Representing Japan, he won World Cup final gold here in Munich back in 2015 and took World Cup gold this year in New Delhi. He's back again.
Tomoyuki Matsuda, Japan. Well, he actually won silver in Munich in 2015 at the World Cup. The world number 5 makes his second consecutive air pistol final. He won his second career gold at this season's opener in New Delhi. And today he qualified first with a score of 5.88. Tugrul Ozer from Turkey. He spent the last week at the Islamic Games in Baku, and he now makes his debut in the ISSF Final 8.
Representing Ukraine, he's the Youth Olympic Games winner from
19 years old, Pavlo Korostylov, Ukraine.
Let's welcome Pavlo Korostylov.
The Youth Olympic Champion who won gold in Nanjing in 2014. He also won senior bronze in Munich 3 years ago. And that completes the 8 finalists taking part in today's final. As we know, João, you were just mentioning that a couple of guys have never made it before, and this is something that we tend to seeing, as well as the experienced guys.
Yes, I can say that the older guys are getting out, stopped shooting, and somebody must be in the final, so it must be the younger guys. It's life. And well, I'm still one of the old guys shooting with 52, but
yeah,
one of these days I'm out also and somebody must come in.
Well, parabéns and congratulations on your silver in free pistol the other day. Did you, you must have felt really good after that final.
Yes, I was not expecting that for sure. It was a great competition. The elimination and the qualification was very good. And then the final, well, the final is the final. We never know what is happening, if it's 10.7 or an 8.1. So we just be calm there and keep shooting. And the main score is the 9, as Mikec was saying here with you, because the result is a total. It's not one shot itself, but it's the total is makes the difference.
Well, it was a good return for you, Joao, who in 2015 you famously won gold in both of the pistol events here. And that helped me decide to call you the nickname of the King Costa, which is how you'll be known this day forward. Joao, the King Costa.
I was supposing it was the age.
It's a combination of both.
For yeah. The first competition series.
So we're about to get underway with the competition, and it's going to be two series of 5 shots followed by 14 single shots. So a little bit longer than the last Olympic cycle, 4 extra shots in the final in total. And does it help you recover a little bit? If you have a couple of bad shots at the beginning, at least you've got some more time to come back into the final.
Yes, I think it's a little bit better with 5 shots, these two series. We can make an 8 and some 9s and 10s, so it's better. Also, it's easier for the scores, for the public to see the scores every 50 shots. Sorry, 50 points, so it's not a bad idea, that one.
Well, after the very first shot, Jin was the only one to hit the 10 ring. It was a 10 even. He follows it with a 9.2.
Yes, and Mikec with 8.5. After this final, they can say it was wind over there, but it's not. It's nervous because everybody must be nervous.
Yeah. A little bit of applause in the audience because Matsuda of Japan shot a brilliant 10.7. Jin's just gearing up for his third shot. Mikec came back well with a 10 even.
Yes, I suppose Matsuda now is aiming for these Olympic Games in Tokyo.
Absolutely.
And he's training a lot.
Absolutely. He already won gold in the first World Cup of the year at New Delhi. Well, Jin was about to take his third shot, but he put his pistol down, and it seems like he's readjusting himself there. Korostylov with a 10.6.
Korostylov is another surprise because he is very young. And this, since last 2-3 years, he's in finals with the senior guys. So
yeah,
he's very serious over there with a strange position for his head and his neck. But he's shooting well. And he's appearing sometimes in the final. Maybe in a few years, he'll be always in the final. Never know.
Well, he's only 19 years old at the moment. And don't forget that when he became Youth Olympic champion, he was only 16 years old.
Yeah,
it's amazing. So, of course, this is an indoor arena for the 10 meters air pistol. And, of course, there's nothing like wind conditions. But it's a completely different stability when you're holding a pistol compared to the rifle, because, of course, you can wear whatever you like when you're holding a pistol.
Yes, the big difference here also is in the 50 meters, because outside you have the wind and the light. So yesterday it was a bright, the targets were very bright during the competition. And after 1 hour, we come here inside, and the targets were over there, almost in the shadow. So for me, it was a little bit difficult, but it was difficult for everybody. But it's very strange in the same day, making a competition in two different situations.
Well, Melchuk of Ukraine has shot a 10.8. It's a brilliant shot. Dmitry Gergich, he hasn't hit the 10 ring in this competition just yet, and he's currently in 8th place. With all your experience, Joao, do you still feel any nerves in a final?
Stop.
Does it still play?
Yeah, sure. It goes from 9 beats per minute to 110, 120, but not much. it makes a difference, the experience, of course.
Well, Matsuda of Japan, who qualified first, is in joint first place with the inexperienced Ozer of Turkey. 49.7 was the highest score, and that came from those guys.
Yeah, but it means nothing. You still wait for the next five shots and then the elimination shots, and then everybody becoming nervous.
Yeah, there's seven more shots until the elimination.
Yeah, and it's the same for the guy in the 8th place or the 1st place, because the guy in the 1st place is looking for the score over there and saying, I'm in the 1st place, and also he's becoming shaky.
Stop.
Joao, when you shoot and you lift the pistol, what are the important elements of hitting the target well?
Well, as a year, we must be fast, because we have a time limit. My focusing is in the sights over there, and the pressure of the finger in the trigger. That's the most important over there. And controlling both things in these 10 seconds, that's the time normally we have to do everything and to have a nice shot. And avoiding thinking about the score.
Jin shot a 10.7, which gained a little bit of applause from the audience. He's currently in fourth place, joint fourth at this early stage. He did follow up the 10.7 with an 8.4. And it's an 8.4 from Korostylov as well.
Yeah, so now Jin Jongoh is in sixth place like he was in the Olympic Games. So he already know the way up to go from sixth place to first place. But we are used to that. Everybody was making 9s and 8s.
Yeah, there's not been a 10 just yet in this series. Matsuda currently in 3rd. Mikec of Serbia, he's lifted himself into 4th place at this stage of the final. Korostylov comes back from an 8.4 with a 10.1. Quite an eerie and quiet atmosphere in the finals hall today. They're quite engaged with the final. Mikec 10.4 and Korostylov with a brilliant 10.8, which means he's currently in 3rd. The other Ukrainian, Omelchuk, currently leading the final, and Omelchuk has just shot a 10.8 as well. Great shot. Ozer is shooting well, 10.4.
Yes, I was looking at him and I was seeing that the cameraman was shaking more than his arm was shaking.
A really steady hand.
Yeah.
Great shot from Mikec, 10.7. Jin, a little bit of a difficult series for him, but he ended that series with a 10.5. And Korostylov followed up a 10.8 with a 10.6. Omelchuk won the gold at this very World Cup 1 year ago.
And now the speaker will say he's in first place and he's almost getting out. And now I think the experience comes up. We'll see if the Turkish guy Ozer will keep shooting very well or if he's counting the points.
Well, this is a great series for Damir Mikec, who's lifted himself into first place now. He's leading the final by 0.5. His last three shots hit the 10 ring, and the last two were 10.7 and 10.8. Brilliant shooting from the Serb. And he had a little bit of a difficult free pistol final 2 days ago because he was just on the verge of at least winning a bronze medal before shooting a 7.7. He was visibly quite distressed at that. So it's good to see him back in the final and shooting well again.
I was speaking with him after the final about that. And it was not only Mikec, he had a problem over there. He was in the position A, and when he was aiming, the cameraman came very close to him and filming, and he noticed because now we have new rules. We don't use sidewinders anymore, so if there is any movement, we can notice. So he noticed the cameraman over there very close, and he was a little bit distracted. So it was a 7.7.
Yeah. Yeah, it's really important to mention that it's actually not because he shot badly. He did have the distraction, and the lights gave him a 7.7. But there's some really good shots on the board. Jin 10.5 saw the other Korean 10.8, Korostylov 10.5, Gurgic 10.6, and The next shot is going to be an elimination shot, and although Gurgic shot really well, he is 2.4 behind 7th place now, so it might just see him take 8th place.
Yes, and 2 points in their pistol is a lot. It's very difficult to recover.
Korostylov and Mikec are the joint leaders of the competition at the moment.
For the next competition shot, look.
Jin is currently in 7th place. He finished 5th at Rio 2016, which was the first time since Athens that he didn't win a medal in air pistol.
Whoa.
Seoul shot a 10.7 and Jin shot a 9.3. Go to get your 10.6. He hasn't shot yet. It is another 10.6, yeah. Though. It's 2 10.6s in a row for Dmitry Gurgic, but the damage was previously done, so he's eliminated in 8th place. But this represents a very good World Cup for the Serbian, who won his first bronze medal in free pistol in that final 2 days ago.
Yes, I wouldn't mind to have a medal yesterday and be in the final 2 days also. Also, I'm looking to the score, and I see only shooters from... Far East or East Europe. Nobody from America, nobody from South America.
That is true, yeah. This World Cup has been a little bit strange for that because we haven't seen a lot of Chinese shooters either, which we mentioned a couple of times, which is a little bit unusual.
Well, but it's a year without quarter places. Everybody knows that this is only for the World Cup and not for the quarter place. So they are maybe relaxing a little bit.
Yeah, we're expecting the quota places for Tokyo 2020 to begin in the World Championships in Korea.
Yes, it will start in September 2018.
Well, Seoul, the Korean, has shot a 10.6. That's 3 really deep 10s for him now. That's a really good shot. Pavlo Korostylov leading the competition by a 0.8 margin now. And in fact, 1.8 is the difference between 4th and 5th. That's Mikec and Omelchuk in those places. The next shot is another elimination shot, and Jin's going to need to save himself from elimination here. He's only 0.1 from safety.
Well, that's interesting. A Korean guy against a Japanese guy.
Yeah.
0.1. Yeah, the public is nervous.
Yeah, it's going to be hard for Matsuda, who we're looking at now, to maintain the gold rush that he began in New Delhi earlier this year.
Yeah, I'm checking Matsuda now with his white jacket and without the band, because in the last final everybody was wearing a black band over there, and today nobody has it. Also, it's a different competition, so maybe it was meaning something. I know what it was meaning, but here everybody is thinking about the shooting and nothing else, so nobody has it.
A few people asked about the black band.
Oh yes, the black band, yeah. Yes, I think it's a symbol. It is a symbol of the free pistol. It was called before, and then P50, because it's 50 meters. That we are not sure if it's still on the Olympic program or not. We are waiting for that, and let's see what somebody is deciding about this.
Well, it was a shoot-off between Jin and Omelchuk. Jin just shot a 10.8 and Omelchuk shoots a 9.4, so it's Jin who saves himself in the final. And last year's gold medalist at this World Cup goes away with seventh place today. Well, sometimes when the pressure gets on Jin, he really does take to it well.
It was only 0-1 point and it was very tight, this fight.
10.8, brilliant shot. So Jin stays in the final. It's Korostylov who's shooting really well. It's a 1.5 difference between him and second place now. And Yezhuao, as you say, that black band was a real symbol that united all of the shooters. And we don't really know what the future is going to be of free pistol. It's an event we very much are affectionate for, but it was good to see solidarity on the range.
Yes, everybody was together about that. I still accept the rules of free pistol, no problem. If also the rapid fire is out, then the solution will be a sport pistol or standard pistol where everybody can shoot it. Because rapid fire guys can do it, they have already pistols, and it's not much difference. And the guys from 50 meters, well, they can change to 25 meters and still shoot bullets.
Well, let's see what happens towards the next Olympic program. But there are some brilliant shots going in because Jin has shot a 10.8 for the second time in a row. Matsuda with a 10.9. Both of those were on the verge of elimination and they saved themselves in the final here. This is brilliant shooting. Korostylov, by the way, shooting a 10.7. There are some mean, aggressive shots going in this final now.
Well, I don't know the world record for air pistol. But going like this is going down. Sure.
Well, the world record for air pistol is... Well, would you believe it's a shooter who's famous for rapid fire? Christian Reitz shot a 241.6 at the European Championships as an air pistol shooter, yeah. And he holds the world record.
And he's a rapid fire shooter, yeah.
241.6. Here's Jin, 2 10.8s in a row. Korostylov, 8.6. Another 10.2 for Jin. This is really good shooting now. Ozer, 7.8.
And Matsuda, 10.1.
Well, this is great shooting. Matsuda has lifted himself into third place now. On the verge of elimination, he was. But Ozer of Turkey, the first-time finalist, finishes in sixth place in this final. Obviously, that represents progress for him. So that's a really good final for him. But this is getting really interesting for Jin and Matsuda, who've really been shooting strongly now to lift themselves up in the table. And it was only a few shots ago I was saying that Matsuda's going to find it hard to maintain the gold that he won, but he's suddenly looking very good in this final.
And Jin again is in the last position now for 0.2. So it's another fight for him.
There's a 0.2 difference between Mikec in fourth and Jin in fifth. Korostylov looks a little bit disappointed. An 8 followed by 9.3, but Matsuda got a 10.8 and Jin got a 10.9. This is amazing shooting from the Eastern Asians. Matsuda in third now, Jin in fourth, and Mikec has dropped down to fifth place. Well, there's a 1.2 difference now between Mikec and Jin. This is unbelievable shooting from Matsuda and Jin.
Yeah, and between fourth place and first place is just 1.4, so it's not much.
For the next competition shot, load.
Shots like these are really getting the crowd going now because we're hearing visible R's and O's as the shots are going in. Mikec needs to try and overturn a 1.2 here. He shot two nines in a row so far.
Yeah, but this fighting is Jin Jongoh.
10.5 from the leader, Korostylov. 9.7 from Jin. And from his Korean teammate, the same score. 10.4 from Matsuda. That's really good. The strongest on the board. And it means that Damir Mikec will take fifth place for Serbia. Well, once again, it's his second final of the Munich World Cup. And he is the world number nine, and pretty successful. He goes and hugs his brother and coach, Goran. So Seoul of Korea currently in second place, and he is another first-time finalist, and he's looking very good here. There's a 0.1 difference between Seoul and Matsuda in first and in second and third.
For the next competition shot, look. Start.
Well, Korostylov at, he might have been 16 or at least 17 at that time, but he did win a bronze in Munich 3 years ago at the World Cup, and he's just shot a 10.7. Matsuda continuing steadily here with a 10, even. 10.4 from Jin. Well, that's very interesting because Matsuda has moved into second place now for the first time in the final. This is amazing shooting from the Japanese, who was in seventh place going into an elimination shot. But the two Koreans, Seoul and Jin, are now within 0.3 of each other. And just on the experience, you wouldn't bet against Jin winning a medal here if he continues strongly.
No, I think after this shot, somebody's going to pay the dinner.
Stop.
Jin on the left, Seoul on the right. Can't see what shots have gone in yet. 10.2, and he's overturned it. Jin 10.2, Seoul 9.6. And it is Seoul Sung Seol of Korea who's in fourth place. So Jin and Matsuda have inched their way into the medal positions. And remember, they were sixth and seventh from being eliminated. What amazing shooting. 10.2 from Jin was the strongest on the board. Korostylov hit a 10 even. There's a 2.4 difference between first and second, and 0.1 between Jin and Matsuda.
Again, they're fighting.
There is a real fight between those two at the moment.
So the most experienced now are staying in the final with the less experienced and the young guy with 19 years.
Well, Matsuda is ranked number 5 in the world, Jin number 7, and Korostylov number 44. Here he is. Slow clapping is starting.
Yes, they're starting, but they shouldn't. In my opinion, if they start, they should start first. From the first shot.
They should. It's a good point. They should. A 10.7 from Matsuda and a 9.7 from Korostylov. That's going to help the Japanese shooter a lot. Jin just shot a 9.3. And there's a 1.5 difference between Korostylov and Matsuda now. Well, this would be unbelievable if Matsuda really could work his way into gold, the second consecutive gold of the season for him. And there's a 1.3 difference between Matsuda and Jin now. That was 0.1 before that shot went in.
A lot of stickers on this piece.
Yeah, he does.
He was around the world with that.
It's fair to say he's travelled a lot over the last 15 years or so. Yeah. Matsuda 9.6, got a steal of 9.9, Jin 10.7! But it's not it's not enough to move him up one more place.
0.2 points.
So it's Jin Jongoh who wins bronze medal. He did win gold medal in free pistol 2 days ago. That's his second medal of this Munich World Cup. And it's a third World Cup bronze for him. The last time he won bronze was at the Baku World Cup just 1 year ago. Congratulations to Jin.
Yeah, he was sitting back just between the Serbian guys.
He was. So 1.8 difference between Korostylov and Matsuda with two shots to go. Could we see another twist before the competition ends? Well, whatever happens, Korostylov is going to secure his best ever finish now after winning World Cup bronze 3 years ago. Matsuda, well, he still got a chance to win second consecutive gold after his gold in New Delhi. Two shots left. 10-3, Korostylov. Matsuda 10 even, so it's very much in the favour of the Ukrainian. He's leading the final by 2.1 with one shot to go.
Almost done. Almost 2 points difference. It's too much now for the last shot. Let's see.
Yeah.
Let's see how the heart is beating.
Well, Korostylov, he won't be able to reach the senior world record, but because he's 19 years old, it looks like he's going to break the junior world record here, which is 239.8. Korostylov, 10.2, he's broken the record for a junior. Matsuda comes in, it's going to be a silver for him. 10.1. And it's Pavlo Korostylov who wins the gold medal with a total score of 240.9. It's not a senior world record, but it is a junior world record in a final. So his score of 240.9 breaks the junior world record by 0.9. What a competition for him.
Yes, very nice.
Congratulations to this very, very talented youngster, and very well done.
And he's not smiling a lot, he's just concentrated.
But Matsuda, on the other hand, he is a very smiley guy. Yeah. And Tomoyuki Matsuda, the 41-year-old, he won gold in New Delhi, he's won silver here. That's two brilliant medals in two World Cups of the year so far.
Korostylov is between two world champions. That's the one in 2010, and Jin Jongoh won 2014, and he's in the middle now.
He is. He's going to step on the highest step of the podium. Congratulations to him, and Jin Jongoh, you can see on the right-hand side as well, the bronze medalist. Well, congratulations to these three, and that was a great competition, especially in the second half where we saw a lot of changes on the board. Let's see if he smiles now. He's been announced to the crowd.
Not
a
much.
Little bit.
A little. That's okay. Maybe he's happy.
A half smile. Well, Joao, thank you very much for joining us. We're sorry you didn't make the final today, but we're glad we had you in the commentary position. It's always a pleasure to talk to you as well, so thank you very much.
Thank you very much for the invitation. Thank you.
Best of luck for the rest of the year. We'll see you at the... You're not going to Gabala, but
no.
You will be competing at the Baku European Championships.
Yes, I will be defending one of my titles.
Because you won gold in Maribor 2 years ago in free pistol. At the European Championship. So, very best of luck to you. Thank you very much for joining us once again. And thank you to you at home, as always, for joining us on the live stream or the Facebook Live. You can like, subscribe, and share on the YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We hope you'll do so to help us promote shooting sport in 2017 and the years ahead leading to Tokyo. Thank you very much, and we'll see you on day five, the fifth and final day of the 2017 Munich World Cup.
The bronze medal representing the Republic of Korea goes to Jin Jongoh. And the silver medal representing Japan goes to Tomoyuki Matsuda. And a gold medal, as well as a new junior world record representing the Ukraine, goes to Pavlo Korostylov.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Ukraine.
Say that again.